Hey guys, this is episode 3.5 of Let's Build a Minecart Station, and we are showing you how to make a better Pez dispenser and automatic departing. So first off is the Pez dispenser, which is the rapid pulse. Found a better way than using repeaters and all that crap, so all you do is just put the standard one hooked up to a button and one redstone, and that goes to the door. And just to show you, it works. Next, all you do is replace the torch on the side of this with one on the top of this block. And what this does is allows you to power it from the bottom. So like that. And that helps for using pressure plates for calling the carts, which is another way of automatic departing. And I'll show you that here. So as you can see, what this does is this version with the pressure plate in front of this, it doesn't work here because that powers the rail as well and that it automatically goes off without you. So the pressure plate goes to this redstone, which then goes to the torch. It's different if you want it to be here, because, well, it could be, but it's messier. So I'll show you that. What you do for this one is have it the opposite way, with the corner being here. Does the same thing, goes to the same torch. So that's basically the exact same concept. So this one is, oh yeah, I forgot. The problem with this is that if you wanted to attach automatic departing, this redstone's in the way. And that's a problem, because then you can't put down your ramp track. So you'd have to either move it back one and have it here, or do something like, let's see, you would replace this torch with this block and then a torch on that block, and then you'd put a redstone like that. That's one fix, but then you have the redstone there, which you can cover up with a half block or a full block, it doesn't matter, but it's a little messier. This one is using automatic departing right after, but it's a little scary because this pressure plate also changes that track. So it's kind of unreliable, maybe, because it basically switches back, and then as soon as you go to it, it switches back again. So you could do that. This version, you have it going around like this, and the automatic departing is hooked up on this side. By the way, this block has a torch right there, right below this. So that's basically the concepts. This is the older station right here. It uses this. You have to refill it, or if your inventory is full, it wouldn't work, so pressure plates are probably a better idea. So just replace that. You just take out all this and, oh yeah, another thing is if you use the pressure plate design, you don't need a button here, so it can technically be one shorter. In other words, this rail could be here, this block could be here, this could be here. It basically takes out this entire slice if you want it to. Another thing is that I purposefully built these stations in the worst direction possible, and by that I mean, if you have the detector rail here, like normally, you have the track like that, you put your detector rail, but it snaps to it, and that's bad. So the way I fixed that, and this is the worst possible way, so you could fix it in other ways too. The first way you could do it is this way, have it the detector rail here, and then have it like this, ignore that, have your normal rail here, and then dig down and put redstone under this, which goes to a block, which goes to a redstone torch under this curved track. Now the problem with that, for me, is watch what happens when this cart hits the detector rail. The detector rail is strange in this way because the cart, when it switches, it wants to now go this way. So because it hits the detector rail, it auto always goes straight. It never gets curved. So what you do is instead of having it default like this, you make it default like that. Problem is that your overflow, it can't go through that way. So instead I shifted this lever to the inside of the block where it normally would be, which powers the same rails. And I took out this track and then this track for a second, had the curved, and made it like that, and then like that. It's kind of confusing, but basically this goes up. If it's overflow, it goes down, and it gets to the overflow part. Now this is switching it, so what you do is, it's a little complicated for me, but I try to make it as small as possible. The detector rail goes to this redstone, which only powers this, which inverts the signal, goes down, and it powers this. And once that's covered up, none of the redstone collides with each other, so it works perfectly. So basically, that's what happens. When the cart goes here, it switches and it's nice, and then once it's off, it switches again and it goes to overflow. That's the solution there. And is that it? Let's see. Oh yeah, this is if you wanted to do it the other way. It's just the same. You have the redstone like that. Goes, powers the block, and off it goes. It powers that torch. So this is a cool way of automatic departing, because if you decide to leave, the cart automatically goes back to the Pez dispenser. So I'll just ride this and show you a sneak peek of my newer-ish add-on, which is mainly, I completely give Nicholas R4132 all credit for this. I just made it a little better, because his, depending on the direction, could mess up because it could switch tracks or something like that. He had the whole idea for it, so go look at his video, which probably is on the video right now. I won't show you this until another episode, so bye. Yeah, check out his video if you want to see the full thing. It's basically SMP multiple arrivals, so that's going to be coming up in a new episode up hopefully this weekend. We'll see if it makes it, because I have finals. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you later.